Well, good morning from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to today's International Space Station update. Joining us here inside of the flight control room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, the Orbit 2 team currently on console right now, monitoring the International Space Station during a very busy time, seeing a visiting vehicle departing this morning, the Japanese HTV vehicle, which was backed away just a few hours ago from the Earth-facing side of the Harmony node. All eyes on board the station currently pointed. This unmanned cargo craft scheduled to depart a little bit later this morning, currently attached to the space station's robotic arm. It's been docked to the station since July 27th and will soon release and back away and then set itself up for a re-entry trajectory with the Earth's atmosphere, where it'll pass over and burn up over the Pacific Ocean, bringing an end to the third flight of this Japanese cargo craft. Meanwhile, here in Mission Control, the team's being led today by Flight Director David Korth. You can see him there in the white shirt, and then joining him at the CAPCOM position is NASA astronaut Katie Coleman, serving as the voice communication link between all of our controllers here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. And those astronauts right now are crew of Expedition 32, three of which scheduled to come home this upcoming weekend. Those three over there on the right, the one in the middle, Expedition 32 Commander Gennady Padalka, a veteran space flyer on his fourth flight, and then behind him on the left, NASA astronaut Joe ACABA, and all the way on the right there is Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin. The three have been docked to the International Space Station since May 16th, scheduled to land this upcoming Sunday in their Soyuz TMA-04M vehicle as they touch down on the steps of Kazakhstan. Again, that'll be coming up this Sunday, and we'll leave our other three crew members on board the International Space Station, Russian cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, and then NASA astronaut Sonny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide. The three will remain on board to begin the increment of Expedition 33, with Sonny Williams there all the way on the left taking over the position of commander for that mission. And they'll remain on the station for a few more months as they continue their stint on board the International Space Station. So meanwhile, on board our astronauts, many of them focused around this HTV vehicle as they work throughout the morning to prepare it for its eventual demating from that Harmony node. Joe ACABA working early this morning to set up the robotic workstation inside of the station's cupola and then perform the demate with the common berthing mechanism, that demate beginning at about 6:50 a.m. Central Time today. And following all these activities a little bit later, he'll be closing that out and taking down the workstation. And he'll be at the controls when they perform the HTV release, working in conjunction with robotics controllers down here on the ground in Houston. Aside from all this visiting vehicle activity he's doing today, he'll also be gathering some more samples for the human research facility as he prepares to come home. And we'll also be doing a ham radio pass with a school in Dorado, Puerto Rico, using just a standard ham radio to give a chance for students down on the ground here the opportunity to ask him questions one-on-one. Our other NASA astronaut, Sonny Williams, also doing some work today on that HTV vehicle. She was working to close out the vestibule, so the connections between HTV and the International Space Station. Also worked to install some more thermal covers, continuing some work she was doing yesterday with Aki Hoshide, and then was responsible for depressing or preparing the vestibule for HTV's final undocking. Aside from that, today she'll also be going throughout the station and taking some water samples from the potable water dispenser and also a few over in the Russian service module. Moving on, Aki Hoshide closing out that HTV vestibule alongside Williams and helping out with that thermal cover install. He'll be manning the robotic controls throughout the day alongside Joe ACABA. He also installed a hardware command panel inside of the Japanese module, and also the centerline berthing camera system, which assists both the astronauts and the controllers down here on the ground, giving them a good solid view of the craft as it's backing away from its spot on the International Space Station. He will also have a chance to do a ham radio pass. He did it earlier this morning, talking to a school in Queensland, Australia, And then a little bit later this afternoon, having an event with the Office of the Prime Minister of Japan, inviting the political leader on board the International Space Station to give him a look at what life is like inside for this Japanese astronaut. And meanwhile, our three Russian cosmonauts, starting off with Gennady Padalka, who's the current Expedition 32 commander and is also scheduled to come home this Sunday, working with a number of different biological experiments as he prepares to come back, taking some fluid samples for the Russian immuno experiment, which looks to track changes in the immune system response inside of these astronauts during long-duration space flights. Also working on the and taking some data reads for the Russian pneumocard experiment, which is the study of the ongoing adaptation of the astronauts' cardiovascular system, one of the many bodily systems inside these astronauts that is subject to change as they're exposed to microgravity for long durations of time. He's also working on setting up the Russian Matryoshka experiment alongside with Yuri Malenchenko, that a radiation experiment that tracks the radiation dosage that these astronauts are being exposed to, named after the set of nested Russian dolls. It has a number of dosimeters or radiation reading devices spaced throughout a mannequin-sized doll that is then placed through different parts or different locations throughout the station to constantly monitor the radiation levels that these astronauts are being subjected to. Meanwhile, Sergei Revin doing some standard maintenance work throughout the Russian segment, uninstalling a few lights in the Poisk module where their Soyuz vehicle that they're scheduled to return home in is currently docked, and also taking out some lights in the Zvezda service module. And then our last Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Malenchenko, will remain on board the station, again working on that Matryoshka alongside of Gennady Padalka, and doing some more follow-up maintenance work on the Russian Electron system, which has been going on since yesterday.